Hello everybody, welcome to, after a long time, a vintage video. So no legacy today. I'm gonna step a little bit out of legacy to try and play some Black Lotus and friends. I'm playing Shops or Stalker or whatever you wanna call it, which is a deck that I'm not a fan of, but a deck that I'm going to play in the Eternal Weekend, which will happen this weekend for me, but probably this video will be released afterwards. And I'm gonna try Karn. I wanna see if Karn's sign of Urza can be good, despite Mishra's Workshop does not allow you to cast it. The list that I'm trying is, it's very stock list, it's not like the one that Semperdi played with the Birthing Pod. We have a Thorn, Steel Overseer, Revoker, Ravager, Foundry Inspector, Pyrexian Metamorph, Walking Ballista. I don't like Chief of the Foundry or Angerbook Walker. That's why I am playing two extra lands. Usually it's playing 18 lands. I'm playing 20. Two Ghost Quarter Main, two Ghost Quarter Side, plus Crucible of Words. This is what I feel like the best in the Shops Mirror match. And also, all the time that I lost, I felt like I've been mana screwed or something like that. And Ghost Quarter can also be pretty much a straight mine sometimes, even the most likely post sideboard, or once they realize the ore shops, they just get your they get their basics and you can just strip them away. So yeah, nothing special here, just this current sign of Urza trying to see if can find a spot in vintage. The sideboard I have four cage, four null rod, which Paradoxical Outcome is not a great matchup. I mean, it's fine if you land a Sphere, a Thorn, or a Trinity Sphere, you are favored to win. But post sideboard, things get worse because of Urki's Recall, so a Null Rod can also stop them from, like, you know, actually cast their Urki's Recall through your Spheres, because they rely a lot on artifact mana. I'm not a fan of sideboarding in Null Rod in many different matchups, but yeah, the Paradoxical Outcome definitely felt like a 4-of. Relic of Progenitus, because I need more cards against Dredge. Dredge is a very played deck in real life, in those events. Not that much of Magic Online, but I'm gonna try just the same list. Also, I like having 7 cards against the Shops, because you have 6 plus Chalice, so 7. I mean, Chalice on the play is good, but yeah, still. You want to have 7 cards that are, like, fine. And, I mean, Relic of Progenitus is just 2 mana cycle. It's not the worst. And then, yeah, Crucible and the Wasteland Strip Mine and Ghost Quarter package. So this is the deck. Let's head down to a competitive league. Welcome to round number 1. We are on the play, which is always a very good place to start in Vintage. Not a particular crazy good end, but we do have a lot of disruption. We're going to go with turn 1 Sphere. Then if our opponent leads a Mox in play, we can just Revoker that and strip mine their land. So yeah, we're gonna just attack their mana a lot in this game. They will either have to overpay spells or will not able to play them. Sphere resolved, and that's the basic island into the Mox Ruby. So yeah, we can counter that by just playing Strip Mine into Pyrexian Revoker. I think I like it better than just play another Sphere, because then it would mean that Pyrexian Revoker costs 4 and I can't Strip Mine them. Instead, next turn I want to play like Sphere or Steel Overseer plus Strip Mine. It's very important when you cast Pyrexian Revoker that you check if you're naming the same box that you have. Very often, I mean, now I don't have any mocks, but that's a thing that happens very often. Alright, and now we can just strip both our opponent land to make them unable to play anything. And then next turn, alright, they want to cast maybe, what's that, Brainstorm? Or Lightning Bolt. Alright. What do I want to do now? I think I'm just going to could play a Sphere of Resistance. Maybe that's better. I'll play Sphere of Resistance. So I'm playing against Probably some sort of pyromancer deck. It's unclear if they have a force of will in hand or not. Wow, days. Did not expect days in vintage. Wish I had wastelanded. Alright, Black Lotus. That's good. They just pass, alright. I'll play more Sphere. Yeah, the days really got me. Last turn, had I just wastelanded them? I mean, it wouldn't have changed much. Opponent would have still had days. Alright, so they have Force of Will in hand. They have a second island. Alright, bad sign. They go ahead and Force. So they have Force. So they have Volcanic Island and then the Mystery card in hand. Unless they draw like one of the infinite good cards that there's in vintage blue decks. I'm fine. They can draw Treasure Cruise, Ancestral Recall, Dark Faden, Dig Through Time. A lot of good cards. Alright, I don't play Volcanic Island in face of my Wasteland. I think it's time for me to just play the Steel Overseer. This ancient tomb is ticking me down. I'm already on 10. And we'll go even more down if I don't draw any land next turn. See, my opponent got rid of my threats. I could have played Progression Metamorph, but I would have taken 4 damage. And also. Yeah, I mean, it's a damage melee. If I draw the same Mishra's Workshop, then I'll play Metamorph. Maybe on a Sphere. Or maybe I can just play Overseer and then Metamorph my Overseer. Because then the clock can be very fast with Mishra's Factory. Though my opponent, I assume they're playing Wasteland. Right, end of turn, they're thinking a lot. And can I have a Lightning Bolt? Or they can have a Snapcaster Mage, they can have a Snapcaster Bolt. Alright, they don't. They definitely don't have Force of Will because. Alright, they're tapping out. 5 mana. Is this a Jace? A Jace doesn't do that much. Ooh, Dark Faden. Okay. I can now. Attack Dark Faden and play another Steel Overseer. Arcbound Ravager is very good against. Ooh, Dark Faden is dying. Okay. Dark Faden's dead, and I'm happy for that. Can open can play a 2-drop. Is this a Time Walk? Jace Burning's Prodigy. Alright. So I can Metamorph the Jace, and I would just get a Merfolk Looter. Maybe I'm just better off in Metamorphing the Steel Overseer. Problem is, when am I going to attack with those Mishra's Factory? Is it now, or is it later? Because if I attack now, my opponent next turn will get to flip their Jace and kill my Steel Overseer. So I can also just play Metamorph, copy Steel Overseer, and then activate one Mishra's Factory just to pump it. But then I go to 4 life, and the Lightning Bolt in the graveyard can be lethal. Yeah, I have to be very aware of this. I can also just play Foundry Inspector whistling their volcanic island. Though I'm not sure if I want to mana screw them. Like, you know, this is a tough game. I have to think very well. This Ancient Tomb is almost killing me. So, right now I don't... I don't want to cast this Metamorph. I might just cast Foundry Inspector just to pump it. Yeah, I think I'll do it. And I don't want to blow up the wasteland. I need all those land to blow up the volcanic island. I need all those land. I'm sure my opponent needs all those land as well. I decided to do it now, so that my opponent cannot respond me activating Mishra's Factory by bolting the Steel Overseer. Yeah, I think it's right to keep the wasteland. Very often, like, the game goes in a situation where you're very mana hungry. That's why I like to play 20 lands. That's why I added to Ghost Quarter, because you're very mana hungry with your Mishra's Factory. And at some point, you don't want to tap your Ancient Tomb anymore. So there's that. My opponents can draw all their broken card and win the game, like a Time Walk or Ancestor Recall. Treasure Cruise is basically Ancestor Recall now. Almost. Opponent will probably, yeah, it's definitely the same since my opponent's gonna loot now. Discard Mental Mist, Flash of Storm, Pyroblast, all the useless cards. Still over seven opponents getting it is a very large one. Because it's at least a 3/3 as a blocker. So it's gonna trade with my factories. I guess not. Because the Foundry Inspector is bigger and the Mishra's Factory is bigger. But if my opponent wants to bolt right now, my Steel Overseer, which is probably what they're going to do. This is why I didn't wasteland them, because they still had access to, you know, this pretty solid play. Right, they discarded land, so they must have... Oh, Treasure Cruise, they did have Treasure Cruise. They must... So they need a land to cast Lightning Bolt from the graveyard. Or from the hand, even, you know. Yeah. When you play stacks, you just have to accept your opponent has all those broken cards and you play just this card disadvantage artifact. I mean, it's card disadvantage because you just pay 2 mana, put that thing into play and never get back anything from it. But you also just load your opponent a little. Okay, oh, opponent's killing Foundry Inspector. And attacks. Okay. Okay, I'm not gonna tap this Ancient Tomb anymore. What I am going to do? I think I just kill the Jace and pass. Not sure if I want to activate the Mishra's Factory. Maybe I do. And they accept to die to Lightning Bolt. I need to put up a clock. My opponent has Lightning Bolt, I don't think I can ever beat it no matter what. Alright, mana's not a problem now for them. It's for me because I cannot tap my Ancient Tomb and I have zero resistance. Young Pyromancer. Alright, go down to 2. And I draw an unplayable card. Alright, the deck is not being very kind to me now. And what am I doing here? I can't attack, I have to pass. Lost game one, which is never a good place to be with this deck. And I deployed this sideboard plan against those fair decks, which is Karn, Crucibles, and Ghost Quarter for Foundry Inspector. Because Foundry Inspector just dies to like by force and removal spell, so I just want to have a lands, and Crucible is very good. You can cast Karn pretty easily. And I was sideboarding out the Mox Opal since I was trying Mox Opal, but then I cut it for a second Ghost Quarter main. We can Thrym on maybe Lodestone Golem. It's not great against Lightning Bolts. I think I'll go like this. On the play, with a turn 1/3 in the Sphere. Not much after all, because I got all those Ghost Quarters, which are, I mean, the problem is, you have to get to the, like, lock piece to need cards like Angerbook Walker, which to me are, like, so bad that, yeah. I am now playing just random cards, thanks to this, Mishra's Workshop. My opponent will play two lands. We draw Mishra's Workshop. I drew it earlier. Could have played the Ballista for four. For three, sorry. Now my opponent can play one draw, like, spell now. Oh, they don't have a land. Yeah, the turn 1/3 in the Sphere. It's pretty broken. And I should have played Workshop and Metamorph the Mishra's Factory. It's a very common play that I just played the Ancient Tomb. I should have played the Workshop and Metamorph the Factory. But yeah, doesn't matter. Opponent was locked out of the game. And I think we don't want to change anything. I still want to try this plan. I mean, this game wasn't really showcasing anything, so let's just submit this again. We have once again Thrym Sphere Mishra's Workshop. We have Karn with not many ways to cast it, but hopefully we'll find it. All right, Land Preordain. That's a pretty expensive Preordain. It's like 5 tickets against the one that the other one worth. I don't even know if this exists in real life. Probably does. Top bottom and not doing anything. All right. I guess the Karn turn one. I think I'm better off in just playing a Sphere of Resistance. And if my opponent counters that, I'll go ahead and Thrym Sphere them. If my opponent doesn't counter them, we'll have a Ravager. I think that's a better line than just jamming a Thrym Sphere. My opponent also has Daze in their deck. I'm not sure how Mishra's Workshop and Daze works. If I can't pay one for Daze, probably can't. Opponent does a force of it, which is very likely by the fact that they're thinking a lot about it. Alright, now my play should be very good. Unless they have two force of it, which they don't. So next turn, I cannot I can jam Karn. And start swarming tokens. And this was definitely a great end, so. But I think it's important to bait this deck. To play the lighter threat on first, and then the second one later. Even if you know, if I'm gonna let the force of the sphere resolve, I cannot cast three sphere, but I'm still happy because I have a sphere in play and then a revoker. And now the game is over. I'm playing. I can only cast one spell. We just get another construct. And yeah, I mean, once you got the train sphere down, as you saw in these two games, the match is fairly over. All right, so we won the post-sideboard games. That's always nice with those kind of decks. So we'll be back for round number two. Round number two. That is very land light, but we do play a lot of lands. And I'm fine keeping this hand. Pressure Evoker is pretty good on the draw. Playing against the mirror. What do I want to do? I just want to go score to them. I hope they don't have another land. I don't think I can win the game any other ways. I don't want to cast Chalice. I can draw extra Moxes and I will definitely need them. Not that I want to cast it any other, like on one or anything. I just cast on zero and sacrifice to Ravager. That's the only thing I can use them for. So now my hope is that my opponent didn't have any land and they just kept, you know, a golem to one, which is obviously great. And then I draw land. I kept this hand because we had a lot of stuff to do. Or Shadow Port. Okay, that doesn't do much. And Ratchet Bomb. All right. And I got punished by playing a Mox by the Ratchet Bomb. Golem hits me. Opponent doesn't have a land. Come on, workshop. Factory, huh? If I draw any land, can play Foundry Spectrum block. I mean, any two land, any two mana land. All right, now my opponent is tapping it. So I need to draw right now a Mishra's Workshop. Come on, Workshop. Alright. That's the game. Not very much skill intensive. But yeah, this format sometimes is like that. I mean, I guess this deck, no, the format is very hard to play. Some decks are. Seven, and we're cutting. Actually, I'm not playing all the relics because I'm gonna keep Chalice on the play. I'm cutting Thrain Sphere, Sphere of Resistance, and Thorn of Amethyst. And this is it. Let's go for round game number two. We are back with a turn one Karn. Turn one Karn followed by two Wasteland. I think that should be the way to win this this mirror match. I think this is definitely something great to do. The tokens will be quite large. I mean, that'll be a 3-3 on turn 2. Our opponent played a Ley Line of the Void. Interesting sideboarding. I guess they also have some slots to fill their deck with. Karn is here. We create golems and pass. Construct, sorry, and pass. They have Mana Crypt as well, which is probably the. Wow, okay, so they have a pretty good start as well. What do they have? Cloistered Bottled. Okay, so this is basically Corrosive Portal. Doesn't matter. What does this have? What does this do? At the beginning of your upkeep, turn all cards you own. Okay. All right, I'm going to Wasteland their land. Then I'm going to cast Foundry Inspector. Then I'm going to minus two Karn, attack for four. So why do you play this over Corrosive Portal? Maybe they didn't know the existence of Corrosive Portal since it's a relatively new card. The Cloistered Portal is pretty hard if I just kill it. I just kill it, they just lost their hand forever. Alright, I have expedition map. Another interesting tool to not get flooded. Sorry, to not get mana screwed. They also have a shadow point. Yeah, their deck is definitely something weird. But we are beating down here with this current Scion of Urza. Leon on the Void, they sideboarded in because Arcbound Ravager says when it dies, so this doesn't trigger. I think it's the only thing that I can think. Oh, Crucible of Words. Alright. Crucible of Words as well. Okay, hopefully we will not need that. Now my opponent can have a lot of mana. They can get like a Workshop or Tolarian Academy. Ooh, Bazaar of Baghdad is what they got. This is an interesting deck. I don't know what this is. Bazaar of Baghdad. Bazaar of Baghdad. Discarding Pyrexian Tower? Really? Rescue Shard to Black. Shadow Port and Cloistered Bottle. Bottled Cloister. Okay, reveal two cards. So my opponent now is giving me the worst of the two cards. Oh, they're here in the revealed zone. So we got a Ghost Quarter with a silver counter on it. All right. And I'll attack for 13. That's a pretty good clock. My opponent has a Ratchet Bomb in their deck, but he just decided to not even try. I guess I have a 3-2, so blow that. All right, I'm gonna board out the other Chalice for the Relic. And this is it. We'll submit the deck. What do we got here? We got infinite lands, which is good. And we also got Lodestone Golem. Yeah, definitely like all those lands. I put this mulligan to not much. Three cards is not a good amount. Of cards. Alright, they have Sorcerer's Spyglass. How is Sorcerer's Spyglass in the mirror match? I guess it can name stuff, but... Oh, I'm not loving Sorcerer's Spyglass. I think that Null Rod is definitely where you want to be. Because Paradoxical Outcome is not a great matchup. And so I just don't have any slot. Maybe online you can just not play Relic of Progenitus and play something else. But in real life you definitely want all the graveyard, like more graveyard aid. Even if against Dredge, you're fine. Like since we are playing Ravager and Walking Ballista, you can easily beat Dredge, even main deck. Okay, I guess I should have played Strip Mine. I didn't pay attention to the Sorcerer's Spyglass. Was a little bit too sloppy with my plays. Because my opponent was at zero cards in hand, so I was just like, yeah, whatever, let's just kill this. Okay. Gonna name the Walking Ballista, which is definitely a wise card to name. But it'll still be very large, despite It won't do much. And yeah, I mean, there's nothing much to say, but yeah, I think the mirror match, you really, really want lands. Like, I mean, but getting flooded can be real, but all your lands do something since they're colorless. It's not that you have like Volcanic Island or Island. You can't just disrupt them, you can't just activate your lands. I mean, yeah, you can get Mishra's Worship and Ancient Tomb, but other than those, all the other lands do something. Yeah, GG's. Alright, 2 will be back for round number 3. Unfortunately, on Magic Online, there's only 88 player active, so you get to be paired against the same guy very often. And this just happened, so I'm only going to find a better hand against Stux. And I did find it. We got 2 Wasteland, which is a key. I'm gonna bottom that Mishra's Factory. Because they already have 4 lands, so might as well just find 4. Looking for, like, Steel Overseer, cards like that. But I kick things off with a Black Lotus and the Mishra's Workshop. Hopefully they don't have a... Maybe they just didn't realize that we are the same guy that they just played against them. So, that's my play. And they have a Black Lotus lying around. We just drew 3 in Sphere, which is not a card, basically. Unless we have a Mishra's Worship and they don't, then it can be annoying, but it costs 4 mana right now because of the Thorn of Amethyst. So we will be playing other stuff earlier. Ancient Tomb. I might just Wasteland that as well. Ooh, Smokestack. I think I'll Wasteland. And then they don't put a counter, of course. Because I have no permanent in play. But I can cast one. I can cast the Arcbound Ravager. Or maybe Walking Ballista's better. I just sacrifice Mox Barrel to the Smokestack. Oh, I was wrong. Mox Barrel cost 1 mana, so I can cast Walking Ballista for that amount. So yeah, I guess I'll cast the Ravager at this point. Still sacrificing Mox Pearl to the Smokestack if my opponent wants to pick it up. Okay, they do, okay. Paraction Revoker. I'm not going to suck the Mox Pearl because I want to sacrifice for the Smokestack. I guess I just named it, so. Alright. Now, do I want to play Walking Ballista? I guess I just drew Steel Overseer. Which means that I want to destroy their land. And cast Steel Overseer. And pass the turn. Not sure if I'm supposed to fight this Smokestack. I think I'm gonna sacrifice the Mishra's Workshop since I can go Ancient Tomb, Walking Ballista, and then I just attack for a lot of damage. And yeah, I think that's what's happening. And if my opponent want to pick up the smokestack to two, I think it's fine. Then I will not play land next turn. Yeah, they take it up. So, what am I supposed to sacrifice? I think I'll sacrifice the Steel Overseer and then Ancient Tomb. Or maybe a Ravager. Is this more damage? I think it is. It's 5 right now, so it's the same, but the next turn it's a little bit more because I can pump the Walking Ballista. See, I'll suck these two. If I draw Mox, ooh, Steel Overseer, it means that I can cast Ancient Tomb Steel Overseer. And next turn, sacrifice 3 permanents. And do I kill them? So I put them down to 12. With a Walking Ballista, next turn I can put 2 counters, and that's lethal, so yes. So yes, I do kill them, so this should be lethal now. Yeah, I don't know if my opponent conceded here, but maybe they thought I was about to cast something and the Walking Ballista killed them. But yeah, good game. So we managed it to raise a Smokestack. Cool game, you don't see Smokestack nowadays a lot. So we board out like this, and we are good to go. Welcome to game 2. We kept a hand with Black Lotus into Foundry Inspector, and then a bunch of 1-drop, basically, thanks to the Foundry. Opponent led with a Sorcerer's Spyglass that cannot name Mana Source. It was like Pithy Needle, but they named Walking Ballista over Steel Overseer. That I am going to deploy here. I think double Steel Overseer, it's my play. Had I drawn Mishra's Worship, I would have played my whole hand. That's pretty great. Alright, Pyrexian Revoker. Now it's annoying. It's okay, I just attack with all. I mean, I'll play some Ravager first and then attack with all. Wow, they named Mana Crypt. Okay, interesting. Come on, land. Alright then. I guess I just put a bunch of counters on my things and attack. I gained 1 life. I didn't see any wasteland in those games that we played. Alright, I have a lot of mana, that's fine. I don't have any mana. Oh, they can tutor for something. What is it that they tutor for? Do they have like Ensnaring Bridge? Yeah, they do have Ensnaring Bridge, jeez. How am I supposed to win now? Let me take a look. How am I supposed to beat Ensnaring Bridge? You can't, right? How do they beat it, though? I don't know. I mean, I just lose to my Mana Crypt here. Yeah, alright, I guess I concede. Alright, fair enough. The Ensnaring Bridge got me. I don't think I can ever beat the Ensnaring Bridge. Oh, yeah, I can with Walking Ballista, but my opponent also had the hard lock I don't think I can beat Black Pyrexian Revoker plus Walking Ballista plus Ensnaring Bridge. Yeah, they cannot. Right? Just taking a look if miss something, but I don't think I do, so yeah. Alright, just let's just hope my opponent doesn't achieve that, and we'll be back for game number 3. On the play, come on, good hand. Eh, I guess I'm gonna keep based on my two wastelands here. I'm not a fan of just casting a revoker blank. I think I will wait. I'll just play Soul Ring and pass. Next turn I can cast Foundry and Revoker. Or just Foundry and Wasteland. Yep, and with Workshop and Smokestack. Okay. I will kill the Mishra's Workshop for sure. And now the question is, do I want to revoke her the Mock Jet or just play Foundry Inspector? I think I'll Foundry Inspector. Revoker can name something a little bit better than just the mocks that my opponent can sacrifice to a smokestack. And I'm not sure I want to deploy that many permanents in this game. Not a workshop. Wow. How do I beat them now? So just play Chalice for 0. And then I'll play a Mishra's Factory and a Pressure Revoker. Name him Mox Jet. Maybe, yeah. Cannot name him Ventor Sphere. This Ghost Quarter would have been a better spell, maybe. Something would have been different. But they can also take up to 2 the Smokestack, maybe. If they want to destroy my board very soon. But then maybe if they take up to 2, they are forced to sacrifice Crucible of Words at some point. Okay, they take up to 2. And the Revoker, my Soul Ring. Alright. I guess I'll sacrifice it. Play that. And Ratchet Bomb. Ratchet Bomb can kill just the Chalice now. But killing Chalice means that I can have to sacrifice something else to the Smokestack. So it's a pretty bad spot. I think I'm losing this game. The Hardlock, Crucible, plus Smokestack. I can get Relic of Progenitus. That will save me. Though, oh yeah, that's... Relic of Progenitus would have been instead of a Chalice. Wow, I would have drawn a Relic here. That's something. Had I drawn a Relic, I would have gone Wasteland your Workshop, then Relic Racket. And you have no Worship in the graveyard, though you still have Crucible. I guess you only had one card in your graveyard, so I could have just exiled it. Alright. I'm just gonna suck this 2. Then I'm going to... Let's see what they draw. First. Card. Yeah, if I had a Soul Ring, I could have played Karn. But unfortunately, opponent revoked it. I mean, when I chose to sacrifice, I didn't know that I drew a card. Had I known it, maybe I would have traded with the revoker and then, you know, played Karn. I think the only way I win this game is by just attacking, just like I did Last match, or probably was game one, I don't remember. I played against this guy quite a lot of times. So doesn't even tick up the Ratchet Bomb. Just suck two workshop, bring back a workshop. And what do we do? I guess I'm going to activate the factory and sack these two. It's basically the same, but if I draw. Oh, yeah, I shouldn't have played my land. That was stupid. Why did I do it? That was stupid. I guess now I'm going to wasteland them. Why did it even do it? Guess now they are forced to sack smokestack and the ratchet bomb. So we, yeah, it's actually probably better that I wastelanded. Putting those five cards against our two. I guess I can rebuild slowly. That we are very far ahead in time here. Mana Crypt was a fine draw. Just needed lands at that point. Point away all the mana in the world, not a workshop in the graveyard. Or a shadow port. Okay. And they start drawing cards. If I draw a land here, though, I can jam my card. Come on, land. Foundry Inspector. They still don't have a colorless land to tap my Mishra's Factory in upkeep because the workshop does not allow you to do that. It only adds mana for artifacts. Smokestack and Wasteland. Alright, so they do have the Wasteland Crucible thing now, so I need to draw like an Ancient Tomb now to cast my card. It's pretty hard thing to do. I just drew Ghost Quarter. And what do I want to do with this Ghost Quarter? I don't know, I guess I will play it. Oh, I forgot the pump. I should have pumped on my opponent didn't block. They could have been at 6, which is actually very much different than 7. And I don't want to Ghost Quarter them. I'd rather leave a Ghost Quarter in play so that they don't really want to. So did they just hardlock me again? Okay. Oh yeah, because close to portal just combos. The 0 cards in their in my turn. I think that just got me again. Let's do a little check. So they I cannot deal with Pressure Revoker. I guess I can metamorph the smokestack. Yeah, let's continue. What do I want to sacrifice? I think Steel Overseer. If I draw land, I can cast Karn. Ravager. Alright, I think I'll concede the game. It was definitely a good game. Very, very interesting game my opponent and my deck brought to the tables with this hard lock. Yeah, good match. We'll be back for round number 4. I will wait a couple of hours to join so that we don't get paired against the Zias once again. Alright, I had lunch. I drafted Dominaria. Now I'm ready, hopefully, not to get paired against Zias. I mean, not hopefully. They didn't get paired against Diaz, but they played against the get paired against the guy that played against yesterday. But I don't remember. Because I remember the nickname I Draft the Beats. So we are playing our Stalker deck, and we got a hand with two Moxes. I believe this is a keep. It's not fantastic, but we do have three mana, three source of mana on turn one. Yeah, all right. Yeah, this should be another Pyromancer deck, another young Pyromancer deck. Let's see, what does the Protean says? Bottom top. And then is this a Mox or just that they just pass? If they just pass, I'm gonna... All right, it's Mox Spear, unfortunately. It's quite unfortunate because it means that I can't... name it with Perpetual Revoker. I'm just gonna play Foundry Inspector and pass the turn. It's not the best turn one, but it sets up for something good on turn two. Showing Wasteland is not ideal, but, or maybe they just can't do anything about it. I assume that they don't have any land. top. Okay, so I guess they got lands now. Because they went top and top. I think they were playing like Jeskai Delver, stuff like that. So I think I'm gonna just go Foundry Inspector. Then I can play Revoker for free. All right, a forced pitch the throw time. Okay. Can play Revoker. Name Mox Pearl. Then next turn, I can name Dark Faden. I don't want to trade Foundry Inspector with Snapcaster Mage. Merchant Scroll, so they're gonna get their Ancestor Recall. Okay, drew Black Lotus, which guarantees me to play Pyrexian Revoker. And so this one costs two, so I have access to... I have access to only three mana here. So I want to copy this Pyrexian Revoker to name... name Mox Emerald. I'm not sure if I want to name Dark Faden with the other Revoker or just copy Mishra's Factory. I think I like that better. So I can go Black Lotus, Metamorph, copy the Snapcaster Mage, and activate Mishra's Factory and tap Mishra's Factory to play another Metamorph to copy the Mishra's Factory. Or I guess I can do that first. I can activate. Play Black Lotus. Yeah, I guess I can also attack with that factory. Alright. So I will activate this. Play Lotus. Actually, I'd rather add another color so that Magical Line doesn't ask me to pay for blue mana. So I'll copy Mishra's Factory. And now, I can play another Pyrexian Metamorph. Pink 1, 2, 3. Copy Revoker, naming Mox Emerald. And now I can attack. With... not sure if all of them are just these two. Probably just these two. I'm on a plan to disrupt their lands, so I don't want them to have mana. They will get to play Ancestral Recall now, but this way they just cannot use these two. Now I draw Mishra's Factory, which I don't do anything with. But I'm still going to play... I guess no, I'm not going to play it. Okay, attack with all, They can lightning bolt like a Mox Pearl and plow something. Oh, they can lightning bolt Mox Emerald. Okay, that's better. Now they want to play Mishra's Workshop. If I draw Wasteland, I'll play that. I think I don't need to play Mishra's Workshop. Alright, they have access to 3 mana, so they 4 mana, they can play now Dark Faden. But, oh, Ancient Grudge main deck. And Dark Faden. Alright, with the flashback up. So I think I have now lost. Still going to attempt. I'm not going to attempt to try to do something. They have Ancient Grudge in the flashback, in the graveyard, to kill that. I can draw Walking Ballista, they can get rid of the Dark Faden, and then maybe in top deck mode I'll draw something good, but looks like my opponent has chased him on Sculptor, and I'm gonna concede. So, yeah, against a similar deck as the one we played before, and I'm gonna board in similar way. So Foundry Inspector out for these cards, and probably Lowstone Golem out again against Lightning Bolt. I don't think it's a good card. I mean, it's fine, it's not special. If you play on turn one, it's obviously good, but the fact that they have a Lightning Bolt makes me just want to cut it. Yeah, I'm going with this on the play. Let's see if we got a good one. I'm gonna keep, but I have a lot of lands. I'm going to just play Sphere first, and then I'm gonna play Mox Jet, and probably Black Lotus as well. Now I just hope to draw some gas. Even a card can be casted. More mana. Alright. Play Soul Ring. Play a Crucible of Words. And play a land. I'm gonna hold the second Crucible, because my opponent does play by force. So I have a on my hand into play, though it doesn't do almost anything. Opponent can now Dark Faden, and it's gonna be rough. Alright, Young Pyromancer, come on, something good. Okay, this was probably the best draw I could have hoped for. The question is, do I want to crack Black Lotus? I don't think so. Or maybe yes. Yeah, let's play it. My opponent cannot force this. And I don't know if I'll get to have a better target than two counters on Ballista with this Black Lotus. I already have a lot of mana. So even if opponent kills this, this Black Lotus basically dealt 2 damage to my opponent. Which, I mean, the problem is that I just don't hope for anything better than this. So Sphere dies, my opponent can now go get the Tropical Island and kill my Walking Ballista. So now they also have mana up for Force of Will. Now it's time to draw a card. We draw Pyrexian Revoker. So they don't have access to red mana if I name them Mox Ruby. Which I am going to. Not sure if I was supposed to play Crucible, just because they can just Dark Faden and get it. And since he says, maybe Dark Faden is just devastating no matter what. But luckily they didn't have it. Dota turns ago, they could have... No, yeah, they can easily have Dark Faden in their hand, because when they play Young Pyromancer, they couldn't play Dark Faden because of the Sphere. and last turn I wanted to get rid of Walking Ballista first. Alright, it's time for me to draw something good here. I don't. I draw Sphere, which is not very good against an opponent with 5 mana. I mean, my hand was kind of bad, so it's fine that we are losing. The Crucible Words are not doing much. And JCR should seal the game. I can draw Walking Ballista, but now, oh, I did draw Walking Ballista. All right, I'll attack Jace first. So Ballista for 3. Ping Jace. You remember with new rules, so you don't ping them. And then redirect to Jace. I just pick Jace. Alright, still without red mana. I can go Snapcaster Ancestor Recall. That's pretty great. Do they have a red source? Wow, they don't. Just go to Discord for 2. Crazy. It's got force because they cannot play it. There's a sphere. Alright. We just drew Pure Action Revoker. Let's put a counter on this Ballista. Let's remove a counter from this Ballista. And let's attack. So now the question is, what do I want to Revoker? Do I want to Revoker Dark Faden or Mox Jet? I think I'm gonna Revoker Mox Jet. My opponent has easily like by force, like everything they need. And if they just play Dark Faden here, I don't think it's like amazing. It's obviously like fine, but they're gonna steal my Revoker and then I can just kill. Alright, I drew a Volcanic Island, so they can play one red card. It can be by force and can be devastating. But at least the Revoker is one less. Alright. Yeah, could I name Mox Ruby again? But I think I name Mox Jet to just prevent them from casting like a bunch of things was better. Not that I can. They can have access to one red card, and it can be like Snapcaster Mage. It can go Snapcaster Bolt. It can be Dark Faden. There it is. Okay, gaining control of that artifact. Draw Sphere. Kind of crazy that I didn't draw any of my 10-9 any of my 9 destroy land effects to go off with this Crucible. Alright, can I attack them and deal 1 damage to Dark Faden, or I can just attack Dark Faden? I think I'll attack Dark Faden and play a second Sphere. Oh, I made a mistake. Should have played Sphere first when the Dark Fade, when the Revoker was in play, so that they couldn't force. Alright, my bad. My bad. But I'm not that unhappy. I mean, unless they play like a broken card now, if I top deck a card, a creature, that'll stick into play. I mean, Sphere was fine, but nothing special. They already have infinite mana. And now we're stalling. They discarded Force and Jace earlier when they went to discard. Must be packed with good cards. This is a treasure cruise, I feel like. And that cannot be good news. Remember, treasure cruise with sphere in play, you can just dealt one more. So you can pay one. Don't remember with three in sphere how does it work. If you can, I think you still have to pay three in the end. Ancient Grudge and Dead, sure. Here my plan is to just draw. I guess now there's an Ancient Grudge in the graveyard. I think my plan is to just lose at this point. Top, top. Monster Mentor. I get Federal Walking Ballista? No. Alright, good game. O2 against, yeah. Against Jeskai Mentor, I was call it. So we'll be back for round number 5. Welcome to the final round. Yet again, on the draw, we've been on the draw for almost the duration of the league. And I have to mulligan this end. What happened? Oh, okay, Serum Powder. Alright, playing against Dredge. Haven't played against Dredge in like 3 leagues I played with this deck. Which is a lot. This end against Dredge is very good. We have Throne of Amethyst, which turns off all the Cabal Therapy and everything else. I guess they have Petrified Field, so they can still pay mana. And, wow, they exiled 18 cards. One Archimeba, two Bloodgust. Alright, I'm keeping this, and this is very good. We have Arcbound Ravager and Walking Ballista to turn off the bridges. And then we can Metamorph more Ravager, and then hopefully attacking. My opponent is struggling to find that that Bazaar of Baghdad. It looks like they kept though. Okay, Sphere Bottom. I want to find a Wasteland. Or maybe they play Main Deck Hollow One. Yeah, do play Main Deck Hollow One. So you used to activate Bazaar end of turn, but now that there is a Hollow One in the deck, you just activate in your turn. Alright, Drugo's Quarter, which I'm gonna play and kill the Bazaar with. Then I can Ballista for 0 to kill the bridge, but I think I still have time. Can do it later. Maybe my opponent mills another bridge. They did exile one bridge earlier with the 3 Serum Powder. I hope this is big enough. I can't make it bigger. Alright, they dredged 5. Oh, Petrified Field. Alright. Opponent dredged very well. And now they have a lot of power and also Bazaar of Baghdad soon. It's gonna come back to hand. Not in a good spot here. Opponent will have a 3-3 end of turn. And I can see myself losing this game. Opponent has a good Garrograve Troll in the graveyard, so they can dredge 6 next turn. Yeah, I was hoping opponent didn't have a Petrified Field and no Mother Bazaar Baghdad, considered that a mulligan to 5, but it did have it, and I'm here. So, I don't want to play Thorn of Amethyst. I can just play a Walking Ballista and just block and sacrifice. Then next turn, maybe Ravager can be large. I think for now this is my play. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have any land to get back the Bloodgusts again. Wow, opponent had 2 Bloodgust exiled and still managed to find 2 in the top, 10 cards. Alright, Narcomoeba, what's the other card? Alright, Metal Mist up main deck. Don't care about that. There you have 2 Bridge from Below. So that will go. Sorry for that. So they got Stinkwedimp and Golgari of Troy in hand. Now they will get back the Petrified Field. Maybe they attack first. Alright, they have Cabal Therapy in the graveyard. But they didn't want to use it. They attack first. And now I think I'm going to do block and shoot the Blood Guest. She's gonna come back. I should Narcomoeba. It's actually better. I'll shoot Narcomoeba. The Ballista should go in the graveyard first. Yeah. Okay, so the bridge will be exiled. Opponent will only have one bridge left in the deck. 24 cards though, so they can easily find it. And they put me down to 14. The problem is that I have this land is Ancient Tomb and not Mishra's Workshop. So I will have to lose life every time I tap it. And yeah, now my opponent can dredge. So draw two, so they can dredge at least five. And they can also Cabal Therapy, since they will get back the Blood Gusts. Can name a Ravager pretty easily here. They could have also targeted it themselves. But yeah, I think a Ravager, Arcbound Ravager, here is the named. Walking Ballista the name, okay. Alright, what do I want to draw here? Maybe Mishra's Workshop is the best. Maybe it's not good enough. Opponent will get to draw two and discard three. The dredge five. Let's see if they dredge more dredgers. In Vintage, you play four Imp, four Golgari Grave Troll, and Golgari Thug. They didn't dredge anything else, any other dredgers. So they discard. Oh, I guess there was a Darkmoor Salvage somewhere. So they have a Cabal Therapy. They can also reanimate Elish Norn with Dread Return. How do I beat Elish Norn? Oh, Protection Metamorph. Protection Metamorph is a good one to beat Elish Norn. Now, how do I proceed here? I don't think I can win at this point. I'm just going to concede. It was a good game though. We had a shot. Had my opponent not had a Petrified Field, we would have won. Top decking that Ghost Quarter was really the key. So I'm gonna put back Ghost Quarter. I'm gonna put in Ghost Quarter, Cage, and Relics. I'm gonna cut Karn. Chalice. I think Golem can be cut. What else? I liked all the creatures because of the Ravager and the Bridge. But I do have to cut something here. I played against... Pressure Revoker was the cut for me. And what else did I cut? Can cut some lands here. Like an Ancient Tomb. Mishra's Factory is actually pretty good. Maybe I don't need all the sphere, but yeah, no, actually I need them because they brought in a lot of one mana, a lot of spot removals. I can have Crucible of Words for one more Ancient Tomb, maybe. In the end, we brought in two Ghost Quarter and we lowered curve a lot, so I think it's okay to cut two lands. Yeah, I will go with this. Alright, on the play with a fantastic hand. I want to play this Radical Progenitus because I don't want it to get I don't want it to get couple therapy. My opponent's mulligan to 4. But they eventually kept. Okay. This is a very good start. I put a lock piece in Thorn of Amethyst and the Relic of Progenitus. So my opponent has to pay 2 mana to kill the relic. Next turn I can just metamorph for it. Metamorph for another relic. And then the Mishra's Factory will put a clock on my opponent. And they just concede. Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. I don't think I want to change anything, so let's just go with this. We are on the draw with a lot of land disruption. Land disruption, I think it's very good. And while we can still lose to like them dredging once at a time, we're post sideboard. So I can just draw my graveyard hate and win the game. Also, there is Thorn of a Sphere that will make them harder to just deal with, like, cast any spell. So that'll slow them down. Alright, they got a Stinkweed Imp and 2 bridges. Do they have a Hollow One? Hollow One would actually be very bad. I didn't think about Hollow One. I was just thinking about them being the old slow Dredge deck. Because Dredge is not a fast deck. I mean, it can win on turn 2. But if you wasteland them, they're slow. But Hollow One could have just made them way faster. So now if they go like Dredge 5, then they don't hit Dredgers. They don't have a land. Or like even a Petrified Field. Alright, what did they hit? They hit Drachmor Salvage and a Golgari Thug. No cards that comes into play. So that's good. Do they have a Petrified Field? If they do, it's okay. They can dredge again. Wow, they don't have it. All right, so this is time for me to deploy my threats. Drawing Gamox wouldn't be bad because I can like drop a Thorn plus a Steel Overseer. Obviously, like drawing a cage or a relic is the best draw. And that's what happened. I just drew Grafdigger's Cage. Which means that I can cast Cage into Thorn of Amethyst, and this will make them almost impossible to resolve. Well, I can have Mental Misstep, but I couldn't have gone Thorn and then Cage this turn. Alright, luckily they didn't have Mental Misstep. Maybe I was supposed to play Thorn first, but then they could have dredged like Narcomoeba, stuff like that. Alright, they chose to dredge 4. Oh, only 2. Oh yeah, they dredged Drachmor Salvage. But I can kill that. And I'm going to. Actually, it's not very smart to kill that because they just, you know, rebuild. Maybe I'm supposed to play Steel Overseer. I can't play Steel Overseer and Sphere of Resistance. Maybe I should just play Sphere of Resistance here. Play Sphere of Resistance because I don't want them to just go land destroy your Grafdigger's Cage. I think they have to draw from the deck now. Can't really dredge 6, but they do. What's their plan? They can't get anything into play from the graveyard. Yeah, they just concede here. Alright. I mean, dredge dies to, I mean, not dies, but we got lucky to draw Cage, as I said, but I think having Wasteland for Bazaar is sometimes good enough, because they sometimes can stumble on themselves. Like, not finding, like, they only find one dredgers and then dredge four. Maybe I could have stumbled. And also, meanwhile, I cast these, so they can't really, you know, play, like, about therapy, dread return, stuff like that. And then I can just draw Ravager to just make their bridge go. I don't know, I think it was a good keep and we got lucky. Speaking of the deck, this is a good deck. And the Karn, I think, added something more for the fair matchups. Like, you know, I see a lot of like energy flux, and Karn is good against energy flux because you can just sacrifice the other artifact and just keep Karn and then just get value and hit your land drop with my sideboard plan of like having infinite lands and then Karn. And then Crucible, I think you can just make infinite land drop and you know, afford to play your spell a little bit better. Okay, hope you had this video was informative. It's reasonable for you not to have a lot of fun because this deck is not that much fun, but I think it's one of the best deck in Vintage, and that's what I'm gonna play this weekend. So wish me good luck, even though this video happened. Maybe you can see now that I've already won the tournament with this deck, or just, you know, went 3-3, medium. But yeah, we'll be back for more videos here on Channel Fireball. So if you like this, please press like on YouTube and subscribe to the channel. There'll be more Legacy. I'm not gonna guarantee Vintage videos, but maybe once in a while, just how I'm doing this. Maybe. But yeah, we'll be back next time. Goodbye.